to homeworld, am I right? Why don't we watch the sun come up and figure out what we're going to do with all this time, eh, Lazuli? And then she'll say, yes, Peridot, as impressed as I was by you on the ship, I am even more impressed with your new compact look and capacity for friendship. I'm so glad we're going to be living together. Peridot, facet 5. Let's begin.
This isn't gonna work.
Wait, what?
I really thought I would be living alone.
Stern Universe here!
Joining her is the Fallen again! Nice to see you guys!
Woo! We're definitely getting this started. We're gonna watch Barnmates.
Yes, after me having technical difficulties for like the millionth time tonight.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
it's yeah, this is what happens when my computer decides that it wants to stop recording.
It's like, I don't want to record. I want to just play around.
It must be karma today. I mean, I had 5 interruptions from my family members alone, and then these computers shut down, like, twice for updating, and then...
Yeah. It was like, oh, come on, computers, don't be mean to us. We love you. And come on, we already just finally found an English version of Barmates, which is...
Oh, yeah, that took, like, 2 hours to find.
Yeah, because French... The France... Dang it, French Cartoon Network somehow got theirs first out, so everyone had that posted more than the English version, so it was just like, really?
Yep. Unfortunately, so we had to deal with trying to find the English version.
Yeah, it's not like
we
didn't mind to watch the French version. It's just the problem was that we didn't want the whole...
We didn't like that we couldn't find the English one. Also, the French one has the old opening. It's kind of boring.
It would be so not right. It wouldn't work because if I got like the link, if I got the episode to it and try to put it on the top of each other, it would sound so weird. And
yeah.
I really,
really won't.
Yeah, and also it's better just to have it on the original airing. I feel like everyone was just cheating their way to watch the episode because they wanted to see the episode, and I'm like, that's the whole point of at least we're gonna have consistency of episodes. Yeah, French decided to get all 3 of theirs first, but come on, at least they're trying to bring ours out again. You know, give us some.
Yeah, I mean, guys. They have to realize that, you know, Cartoon Network relies on how many views, like how many people supposedly view in to watch Steven Universe every week, as well as other TV shows on Cartoon Network, and if they don't see that there's like a good amount of time where people are on their channel during that one show, then... They cut that show sometimes.
Yeah.
So, yeah, please, guys, wait until the day that it comes out.
Show your support for this show. Come on, people. Respect the show. Respect.
Respect Rebecca Sugar and all the people who spent, like, 9 months making these episodes.
Yeah, and then the...
And all the voice actors and actresses, the sound crew, and the storyboard writers, and then the animation people. It's like, please respect them and wait for the day that they come out.
Yeah, because you never know also if they may have changes from the French version to the American version, just like the UK did.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, remember, I was telling you about the, what was it,
the fusion dance of Pearl?
Yeah, was that in We Need to Talk? What was that?
Yeah, it was.
Yeah, I think it was We Need to Talk. They cut out the fusion dance of Pearl and Rose.
Because it was too. They thought it was too gay, so they cut it off.
Lesbians. Lesbians everywhere.
Lesbians!
Even though they're a gender rocks.
Yeah.
That use she and her pronouns. Seriously, guys.
Then again, this is going to be an awesome episode where Lapidop is going to be around.
Oh, yeah, that's going to be interesting.
I'm not.
That's going to be very interesting because, why don't you tell the Moonstone?
I don't want to say it. I hate Lapidop. I'm sorry. I will go away from me.
I thought you were going to say that you don't like Lapis that much.
No, well, Lapis is. I don't like Lapis that much, but I didn't like the couple period of Lapidop because, one, it doesn't seem like a supportive type of relate. It doesn't seem like that there yet any chemistry, and maybe this episode have some.
I will ship platonic Lapidot if they ever get that point.
Platonic, please. I'll keep it the platonic. But
oh, I've been shipping platonic Steve Lapis for like months.
I love.
They're like the two buddies I never want to be apart from.
I'm a Steven Dodd. Steven Dodd romantically, please. I don't mind. It would be.
I'm happy with Connie and Steven. I'm like, on one hand, I would like to see a future of them together. On another hand, I would like them to just be friends in the future.
It's really hard, and that's why I don't like Lapidot, because everyone, do you know how detailed and so fine, they went to the point that they literally analyzed that, you know, that whole Pining Hearts thing so badly that it was, like, they thought it was evidence of Lapidot. I'm like, no, no, stop.
Where did
stop,
they get that
Stop digging,
from?
Stop digging.
I don't see it. And besides, if anything, I think it's pretty much confirmed that Peridot thinks logic first, emotion second.
It would take a long while.
Peridot is very logical with her emotional stances, usually.
Yeah, and it would take
so, which is why she ended up going fangirl crazy over how, and figuring out all the subtext in one episode.
Love you, Peridot.
I wish she was around for half the things I watched. I'd be like, okay, so explain to me the sexual tension between this guy and this guy, because I clearly don't understand it.
We didn't even see the whole episode. That would be kind of fun if they had an extra of actually showing the whole Hearts Pining episode, you know?
Yeah, I like how I'm surprised nobody's like, oh my gosh, Peridot's a yaoi fangirl.
I think some people have said that, but they were so busy looking for the shipping signs. I mean, seriously, there's I'll probably put in the description of Romance Scrooge's video that has explained a little bit about the Lapidot signing that people have been seeing. And as we go to that, we might as well start the video before we start going further and further on time.
Yeah, we'll talk about that later. We're already like almost 8 minutes in. So start the video.
Mm-hmm.
Three,
two, one. Are the crystal gems will always and if you think we can, we'll always find a way. That's why the people of this world believe in Cronin, Amethyst, and Pearl, and Steven! I can't help it. I love seeing this.
I just can't sing.
And then hey, as one refugee, it isn't so bad that
there's a tarp on the hole.
Why don't we watch the sun
and figure out what we're going to do all this time?
I love you!
And then she'll say, yes, Peridot, as impressed as I was by you, even more impressed with your new compact look and capacity for friendship. I'm so glad
Peridot.
Facet 5. Let's begin.
She's
oh my god. You don't do that in front of a person.
She's not used to it.
Yeah, but this is even better. Oh, here, how about this? I saw this on an episode of a TV show.
What?
Oh my god.
What?
We'll divide this place in half. You'll both have your own space. High ceilings, real wood floors, convenient location in the heart of the country.
You're cutting so what do you think, half? Please?
I like the cut of your gem, Stephen Quartz.
No. No way. What's the problem?
Oh my gosh.
You're getting all the good stuff. You've got the propeller and paint cans on your side. You could do tons with those. Ooh, actually, I kind of want the paint cans. You want to try something?
I don't care about paint cans. That's not the problem.
What's the problem?
Oh. What's wrong, Lapis?
Come on!
She doesn't like Peridot.
Uh-huh.
She's the problem. I can't stand the thought of having to look at her every day. She's trying to drag me back to Earth.
Hey, it wasn't my idea. I was I needed an informant. It should have been a simple mission. Things didn't exactly work out for either of us.
You used me like everyone else did.
But it's not like that anymore. It's different now.
Please! Understand you
I sabotaged my own mission. I helped save the Earth. I even yelled at Yellow Diamond. She's probably sending a whole fleet to find me and shatter me right now. I'm kind of a big deal.
Yeah.
Big no, she's deal. Not.
Yeah.
Stephen, I don't think this is gonna work.
Maybe we could put up a curtain?
Damn it, Lapis! Why?
I don't think so. She's going back to the grain silo.
I thought this was gonna be okay. I forgot that the last time you saw each other wasn't so okay.
That was in the past.
It's not like that now.
She
doesn't. She's the one that needs to know. I want her to understand.
That's the you need to show her.
Show her my sweet.
Steven,
something if you can't be face to face with them.
Aww.
Or if they don't want to see your face. You've got to give her a taste of the sweet version of Peridot.
Oh, this is so cute.
Here, look. Oh, that's kind of part of my style lately.
Is not having fingers also your style?
No, I'm just bad at drawing hands. So here's your.
I can relate, Steven. I can relate.
I'm bad at drawing everything, period.
Everything is okay now. If you write it from your heart, your feelings will reach her.
What's a heart?
Just try to be sincere.
Sincere! What's the word sincere mean?
Well, she seems to be enjoying the grain silo.
Why isn't she responding?
I'm not sure. I thought she was up there.
She's up there.
Huh? Are you up there?
Don't respond to Steven right away, but not Peridot.
Steven did the outside.
And I did the inside.
Oh my god.
Sorry I interrogated you. You were just such useful information.
Oh god.
Peridot.
Love you, Peridot, but you're not understand what you're talking
about. The noses!
About.
One can only conclude that it was the lack of noses! It seems illogical to me that it would be any of the writing elements. It's and I was the most sincere as per Steven's instructions.
It could be she's just not much of a reader. How about a gift?
Another approach.
Oh, God.
Yes. Aww. I really wish that everyone else was here, because that would be funny.
Lapis lazulis are typically partial to water and flying.
Oh, there goes my theory from before.
No,
it's been debunked by Peridot.
Okay, again, that goes my theory of not homeworld not having a lot of water. My mistake.
It happens. Everyone didn't know. I think it probably is.
You can see through those, right?
Actually, yes, but it's very blurry.
Good to know. Well,
let me see.
Oh my gosh, it's a smaller than average lake.
It's from the hole when we drilled. Peridot and I sealed it and filled it with water.
It's for you.
You know, because water's your thing.
Pretty good, right?
The barn's out here in the country, but now you can get your moisture fix whenever. Do all that water stuff you do.
Seriously?
Oh god!
You realize that I spent the last few months trapped under the ocean, right?
Sure, but I
thought
it was an endless
crushing.
Oh god! Oh, what the hell is going on? I feel this weird.
Oh god!
Oh my god! I feel like I just met a gothic chick.
Thanks.
Like a gothic chick met a nerd. You know, that's what it looks.
Don't
worry, Steven. It's not your fault.
It is his fault. He was trying to do his specimen.
What a cry idea! Of course she wouldn't like that. There's nothing. Nothing. Nothing.
There has to be something.
She really is trying. Why, Lapis? Why, damn it?
Give her something you like. A piece of you.
Okay. Well, I do say that if you are having trouble giving a present to somebody, give them what you would want.
I know.
Wait, she has a camp pining heart CD.
Whatever. That's it. Whatever. Whatever. Clearly, there's nothing important enough for me to give to Lazuli. At least I have you, tape recorder.
Oh.
Ta-da.
Oh, he's just gonna give her. Oh my god, she's gonna
see,
do it.
The ribbon is even blue. I got your number.
Oh my god!
Here, I'll unwrap it for you. When I was stuck here, Steven gave me this tape recorder as a gift, and I didn't really get it at first, but it made me feel better. Just to talk about all the weird stuff that was happening. It'll help you too. You, press the button to record, and then you talk into it.
Oh.
I don't want... You're garbage.
Oh, crud. Bad job, Lapis.
What, were you trapped in a tape recorder, too? Look, I get it, you know. You're confused. Oh. You can never go back to homeworld. This place doesn't exactly feel like home yet. You're alone. No one could possibly know what that feels like. Oh, wait, I do. We're the same, except... You don't have to be alone. So tell me then what you want from me. And whatever that is, I'll do it.
Love you, Perry.
I want you to leave.
Oh god, Lapis, seriously?
Damn it, Lapis, you are such a give me a baseball bat and start.
Hey, she's my favorite character, and I still don't like this.
She's really trying. Why do you trust her, Steven?
Because I know her. Lapis, you're not even giving her a chance. You should have at least gotten to know her before you decided you don't like her. Now it's too late. And she's never coming back again.
Oh, look, she's coming back.
What? Oh, no! Yellow diamond, people!
Run!
What the fuck?
What is that thing?
It's a roaming eye. A homeworld tracking vessel. I told you.
Wait, didn't I see one of these earlier in season one?
This is not good.
It's not good.
Not good at all.
Mm-mm.
I think this is for the next episode. Oh my god! Dang it! Damn it, that hole!
I like that picture of all of them, like, oh my god.
Holy god, no! Oh my god!
This is it,
Steve! Ah, so cute! Yes, 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 yes!
Stay
behind me, my pretty!
I have no idea if she's doing this because she feels bad for her, or it's because it's Steven.
It could be both. Oh my god!
Holy smokes.
Steven!
Oh my!
Are you alright? We saw the ship and came as fast as we could.
Yeah, I'm okay. Lapis saved us.
Lapis just did this! BAM!
The world really has it out for Peridot.
Peridot.
Oh gosh.
Are you okay?
Look at her face! It's so cute! I want that face now! Okay. What?
Ruby.
What? What? That was a ruby. Holy shit. Oh, wow.
Why is the ruby in... okay?
I guess that's for the next episode, but I...
No, I was referring to the fact that the ruby is in its eye?
Well, they... I never
I don't think it appear anywhere on the body. It just seems weird.
Well, maybe it's because... I guess they were trying to find different places for it, and they thought the eye would be the best place this time, so they decided to put in the eye for this one.
I guess.
I kind of wonder how you get a weapon out of that. Like, zip.
I don't know. I saw an interesting theory with that some gems may not know how to summon their weapons.
Well, I mean, the other rubies did his. I mean, Ruby, Garnet Ruby, can do it. I mean, you saw her when she says, "I'm eternal flame, baby."
Yes, I'm an eternal flame, baby. Punch table.
Yeah, so I don't know about that. Maybe it's because it's going to be maybe a different weapon than the gauntlets. Maybe it's like a weapon that's much more comes out of, like, like every...
Maybe.
Maybe every gem.
Or they might be similar. You never know.
That's true. I mean...
Though, I do find it interesting one quick thing. I do find it interesting that Peridot said that Lapis Lazuli are partial to water and flying.
Partial.
Which means that many Lapis Lazuli can fly. I like that. I like that.
I guess.
Sorry. I just had to say that. It's like, oh my gosh.
All
Lapis Lazuli like flying.
Everyone.
This is a thing.
Everyone loves they love flying. But... maybe they do not have as much water, because, again, if she's that powerful, why couldn't she do it in Homeworld? My god!
Okay, so maybe my theory can be adjusted that maybe Homeworld has minimal supplies of water versus vast amounts of it, because if they are partial to water, they probably stay around the only watery places, then. Or wherever Blue Diamond's located, I don't know.
I don't know, because the last time we saw a blue diamond was she was in the sky above the earth.
I remember, clouds are just water.
It's like water. It's gonna be...
Okay, let's start with... What is it, the thing that you like the most about this episode so far?
I happen to actually like how Peridot really was trying to be friends with Lapis Lazuli and not getting super... Like, just like, I give up being her friend. She's just so horrible and so nasty. I mean, she could have done that. She just could have just said, fuck it. No way. I'm not going to do anything with her the way she's treating me. But no, she really just really, really wanted to be friends with her, because she knew and understood the feelings that she was feeling. She knew that she didn't want to be alone. Someone who's also a homeworld gem, who didn't understand Earth. It's like... some kind of connection. It's important for her just as much as she wanted to do that for Lapis. So it's so cute. It was so adorable. And I also like...
Yeah, that was cute.
I also like the little bit of Steven Dodd feel. Maybe it was because it's my fuel. Ray made
yeah,
the fuel.
It's like one of your OTPs.
It's like, fuel me, my pretty. Fuel me. What about you?
To be honest, I kind of also love that with, like, Peridot being, like, she is so, as I said before, she's so logical about things and logical about even her emotions, to the point where it's funny because she doesn't really tap into her emotional side the best, so a few of social cues she doesn't know, like, hey, Peridot's been under the water for like 6 months. Maybe it's not the best idea to give her water. But logically speaking about Lapis Lazuli, as she said, Lapis Lazuli loved water and flying. So she was actually trying to give Lapis something she thought she would like. However, the social cue of, if somebody's been somewhere for a while and they didn't like it, you probably shouldn't remind them of that place.
It's kind of hard.
Yeah. Yeah. So, I found that funny. And to be honest, I kind of do like, I know it's bad, but I kind of do like that they make it really hard for Lapis to accept things, because I think that is part of her personality. She is a bit jaded in that regard. I don't expect her to jump into being, oh my gosh, you're my friend now. La, 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 la.
Yeah,
you know what I mean?
That's very
it's
true.
Like, I like how they make that flow, I guess, is what I'm saying. I like how that's, they're trying to change her character relationship with Peridot, but they're not going to go with the shoujo anime aspect of it, is we're suddenly enemies, so we're suddenly friends.
Yeah.
It's like, I hate you. It's like, I hate you. Okay, I guess I don't really hate you, but I still don't like you very much.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I like how it just, they're making it, like, grow a bit.
Mm-hmm. That's a good thing, because I always wondered how easily she's able to connect with Steven, but then again, I understand he released her, but I was like, you even trust her? Oh, wow. It was so cute how she just, like, suddenly responds mm-hmm. to him more than anyone. Just like, Lapis, down, she goes.
Yeah, well, honestly, I think it's because, even with Peridot's wording, remember, Peridot said, thank you for the useful information. Lapis is focusing on the fact that she's been used by people, so that's what she's connecting Peridot to, and it's bad memories. Crystals before her, trapped her in a mirror, used her to try to get information. She goes back to homeworld, Peridot's going to Earth, Lapis was at Earth, Lapis has information, use Lapis for information. It's kind of like, I guess, is more of a, I'm gonna guess it's more of a trauma thing, where, I mean, if anyone in the comments could correct me if I'm wrong, I apologize if I'm getting this a bit off base. I am not a psychology major, so I get things a little off base sometimes. But I honestly think it's just more of a bad experience. It's being used, bad experience, being used again, even worse experience, and because Peridot's right in front of her, it, you know what I mean? It doesn't help.
I can't imagine if she, when she meets Jasper again, it's gonna be like a all hell break
oh
loose.
Oh god.
All hell break yeah. loose.
Yeah, but I think the reason why she trusts Steven so much is because from the first time, Steven wasn't actually trying to use her. He's like, oh cool, a pretty mirror.
Oh look, my butt summer fun buddy.
Yeah, pretty much. He wasn't really focusing on the fact that, like, oh, I could use this mirror. It's like, oh, well, apparently the mirror, she's, Peridot's like, oh, I guess the mirror's broken. You can have it. It's like, oh, cool, mirror.
Oh.
And he just goes running around town. He doesn't, it's not like he, was purposely using it for, using Lapis for a reason. It's just like, oh, cool, now we have a summer fun buddy.
Yeah, and it was, he was, like, really wanting her to be hers. Really his great good friend, and that's what it, I can see that's why he's has such a connection with her, because she, all she can think about with him is that the good action he did, and the same thing with Peridot, she can think about her is that all the bad things that happened to her
mm-hmm.
with her.
Yeah,
dislikes
You know how I said I like the fact that they didn't make her go flip-flopping to being I really hate you to I really like you? That doesn't necessarily mean I liked Lapis's attitude. It really, even for me, I'm a big Lapis fan. Lapis is my favorite character. My favorite characters even tick me off at times. And this entire episode, this is just, I was just like, anyone who's watching this video can see my reaction of, oh god, oh god, oh god, Lapis, what the hell, what the hell? Your attitude is too annoying right now.
I know the feeling, that's pretty much my dislike, because it's like, I wanted to beat her with a I'm not a big Lapis fan because maybe it's because of all that's her the problem. That was the thing that made me agitate her agitated me the most is her attitude. When she becomes like this weird one-dimensional attitude about towards someone, it just pisses me off, wants me to get it back and start hitting her with it.
The thing is, I see it as realistic, which is why I like it so much. Lapis has been through a trauma. She relates things of a traumatic experience back to the first trauma, so she wants to avoid it.
Yeah.
So therefore, she wants to avoid Peridot. Because Peridot is right there physically, it brings up all of those bad emotions. However, I still don't like her... it's not even passive-aggressive. It goes from... She's just plain out ignoring Peridot's existence, if possible. I kind of hate.
I was like... Again, I'm probably in the side of Peridot because I'm like her in the sense that I'd be like wondering, what the hell, what's this going on? I'm trying everything. I'm not doing anything wrong. I'll be like the same type of person. I always would wonder what I did wrong. So when I'm seeing Lapis, it's more like I'm looking at her doing the same thing to me. I'm like getting angry at her at the same time. Like, gosh darn it, why are you being mean to me? I'm like,
yeah, I get it. I'm just saying I could also see Lapis's character as somewhat realistic. So it's like I have a love-hate thing with it. I don't like how aggressive, I guess, with her hate. It's not like she puts it in it's her tenacious. She's like, I've been stuck at the bottom of an ocean for the last several months. Do you think I want to be around water right now? For those months, water was my tomb.
My God, when I saw that moment, I thought I was watching some weird, depressing...
Shonen anime?
Yeah, like something like that. Or I met a gothic character, like, in front of my face and started... You know, one of the stereotype gothics.
You mean a depressing stereotype goth, not the actual goth.
Yeah, that kind of goth. And I was like, oh my gosh! Oh my gosh! Like, what the hell is going on?
Yeah, I'm like, okay, Lapis, nice to see ya.
Yeah.
Lapis, would you like some therapy? I'm pretty sure Steven can help.
We need some therapy. We need therapies.
Well, I remember somebody mentioning that, Steven... One of Steven's powers is literal empathy. Like, it's not the figurative empathy, like, such as putting yourself in the place of somebody else and trying to feel what they feel. It's he literally feels what another person feels. Steven is an empath, which is why he gets along with so many individuals. Because he can do that. Which is why he's like, I want you two to get along, because I know how Lapis is, I know how Peridot is. You two should get together because you can be friends.
Yeah.
And I think that Steven's struggle in this episode is because he knows their feelings in general as just autonomous beings, that it's like, he knows that Lapis is homesick. And he knows that Peridot is homesick, and he knows the depths of both their feelings, even though Peridot's, as I said, Peridot's very logical with her feelings, too, but
yeah.
You know what I mean?
She tends to, like, be a little bit more blunt. She, like, tends to be like, okay, I'm telling you my feelings, but my feelings are saying, like, I'm sorry I interrogated you. It was very blunt. She didn't understand that those were kind of words trigger something. She just didn't understand.
It wasn't intentionally her trying to be sarcastic or mean, but that's how Lapis took it.
Mm-hmm. So it's very... it's interesting. And this is a very interesting episode.
Yeah, I mean, Peridot said she spent over an hour deciding her words. Again, with Peridot's very logical about her stuff. But Peridot's very serious, and that's kind of like, she was really trying, which I actually loved about this entire episode. It's like, Peridot is really, really trying to impress Lapis. It was I want you to be my friend. This will be fun. Come on. We can share the barn together. Oh, wait. Actually, I want that paint. Can you trade something for the paint? Which is different from before, because she kind of seems like she would be, like, earlier episodes seemed like Peridot would kind of almost demand or just take it on her own without asking. But in this regard, she was actually asking, Lapis, can I have the paint? I'll trade you something.
Well, it's most likely it's because, like I said, being around Steven and being around the Crystal Gems, she kind of had to learn how to say those please and thank yous and all those nice things in order to get what she wanted now. So now she's understanding that the only way that you can get what you want, you have to be nicer in this planet.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Which, again, character growth, I love it.
It's so cute. But, yeah, this episode was really great. I'm already going over, we're already going over our time.
Oh, yeah. Well, that's because we kind of ranted a bit in the beginning. Okay. Yeah. Alright, final thoughts? I think this was a pretty good episode. I think they could have changed some stuff when it came to interacting with Peridot and Lapis.
So true.
But honestly, I think the storyboard writers did a pretty good job trying to develop both their characters.
I also hate the cliffhanger so much!
Oh, so, yeah, that is the one thing I'm like, okay, then.
Damn, we have.
Well, apparently this leads into, I guess, what's supposed to be the baseball episode?
Yeah, it's
from the title.
It's called Hit the Diamonds, I think it was called.
Honestly, I just saw the title for it, and I'm like, is this involving baseball?
I saw a few pictures, it seems to, but I'm not going to do any more dive into that, because if I do that, then people is going to put on my comments, watch it, it's right there already on Dailymotion. No! French,
no,
go away.
No,
leave.
No.
Wait until next week. You can all wait until next week for me to...
Wait until Moonstone decides to watch it herself or do a video collab. Don't ask her, please. Even here, I'll say it for you. Guys, please don't pop in Moonstone. She and I want to watch it the week that it comes out for the US. It's more fulfilling that way, and also, let her watch it on her own time. I mean, she's busy too, and she has to edit all these videos. Calm down! Okay.
Thank you.
please let my friend do what she wants. I mean, you guys are waiting for her videos anyway.
Yeah.
Just don't jump the gun.
All right, everyone. Peace out. I will see you guys later in the next video.
All right, guys. Until next time, this is The Fallen signing off.
Moonstone Universe signing off.
Bye now.
Bye.